You know, he couldn't even hold his arms up. You know, he couldn't even hold a fucking fork. There's nothing wrong with his brain, though. He knew what was going on. I knew what was going on. Both just kept on together. Day after day. And he just wasted away. You know, you got all these fucking nurses, you know. They're flinging him about. They're saying, stand back. We know what we're doing. I said, well, if you know what you're doing, why does he look like a rag doll? Fucking hold him up. And then he had to have someone with him, you know. Help him wipe his ass. Help him piss. He would have had to have someone with him every minute of the rest of his fucking life, following him around with a shit bucket and a mop. Oh, and then this one day, this first year fuck of a nurse, she comes in and she just dumps this tray of shit in front of Dad. This brown shit, this cup of jello, that lime green kid shit, just dumps it in front of him. And he just looks at it. He's just humiliated, you know? Just dumps it. I saw him. His eyes. Everything just disappeared. I was holding his hand and he squeezed it and I said, do you want to say something, Dad? And he said something, but I didn't hear what he said. So I said, why don't you whisper it, Dad? Just whisper it. And he whispered in my ear. I said, no, Dad. No, I can't do that. And he just said it again. I just stood there. And then I did it. I just did it. Told me to do something. I did what I was told. He shouldn't have hit you so hard. He never should have hit you so hard. Now what's inside of him is inside of me.